Welcome back to Portland today. We are gearing up for the Soapbox Derby this weekend. This is Wally, one of the vehicles that will be racing interactive. Wally, are you excited for the solar eclipse on Monday? That's a yes. Wow, this is so cool. An interactive vehicle. You don't find that very many places. John Swanson joins us now. He's the president of the Soapbox Derby. Okay, so tell us all the details. What's going on this weekend?
Saturday, August 19th, we're going to be at starting the races at 10 a.m. on Mount Tabor. Everybody's allowed to come. We're happy to have anybody show up. There is alcohol permitted on the hill. There will also be beers from Gilgamesh Brewing, and there will be plenty of food carts there, including Bunk and PDX sliders. We're happy to run this for the 20th time.
Wow. And this is absolutely free, correct?
Yes, it is.
Okay, let's take a look. Anybody involved. Let's take a look at some of the, racers, you would call them. We will see. So this is Wally. So interactive. Can we take a look behind Wally and see how number 17 is going to roll during the big race? So tell us what's inside.
The magic is inside, actually.
You were telling me two people can fit inside here?
Two people do fit in here. We have a driver and a ballast, I suppose. This is considered an art car, a little bit slower, but still a wonderful contender. This year, Cirque du Soleil is going to be judging the art car.
Wow! And how many vehicles and cars are we going to see this weekend?
There will be 46 or 47 cars this year. A little fewer than last year, but still a great turnout, and we're really excited to see everybody on the hill.
Now, you mentioned the art category, which I think Wally is going to kill it and win. Now, tell me about the speed category, and this vehicle that you mentioned, someone is going to go head first with this guy?
This is a race car gravity slave. The rider literally lays down on his stomach, rides head first, obviously helmets for everybody who races.
Sure.
But especially on this one. He's been running this style of car. The driver has been running this style of car for a while. Well, I always thought it was insane, but he's very good at it, and he's a great builder.
How does somebody get into Soapbox Derby racing?
Keep an eye on soapboxracer.com, okay. Or for that matter, our Facebook page, which is Portland Adult Soapbox Racing. And we all have a sign up every April.
Okay.
And you pay your $200, you are first come, first serve.
Okay.
And you can build a car at that point and race it on race day, which is the third week of August, which happens to be this Saturday.
Now, I heard really quickly that maybe don't bring your pets or your kids because you can really get close to the action, but they might want to stay back home.
It's very, obviously, racer safety as well as viewer safety is very important to us.
Right.
We want to ensure the safety of all the racers and their pets. Please leave your pets at home if you have the opportunity.
Yes.
Children need to be kept track of because obviously they have a tendency to get very close to wonderful things.
Yes, absolutely. And all the info there on your screen. Again, the Soapbox Derby happening this Saturday. I don't know, you guys. Would you go head first on this bad boy? I could see Drew maybe trying this out perhaps with a helmet. Maybe?
Absolutely. A year ago this very week, Kathy McKenzie, I did preview this very event, and we went down a small hill. But I'm glad they brought up the safety issues because this is no joke. They are barreling down that hill in some of those racers.
And do they have brakes?
Yeah, they have brakes.
All right, McKenzie, thank you.
Thank you, McKenzie.